Hi, my name is Beaubrun, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi Associates. In this video, I'll be talking about motivating operations, specifically conditioned motivating operations. This falls under Area B12 of the BACB task list, which is defined and provide examples of motivating operations. Conditioned motivating operations value altering effects that are learned, which means the organism has a previous learning history with the stimuli. Conditioned motivating operations are neutral to the organisms before they're paired with unconditioned motivating operations or reinforcement or punishment. There are three types of conditioned motivating operations. Surrogate conditioned motivating operations, or CMO-S, reflexive conditioned motivating operations, or CMO-R, and transitive conditioned motivating operations, CMOT. When describing surrogate conditioned motivating operations, it's the pairing process in which a stimulus has acquired a reinforcing value of another stimulus by accompanying a stimulus that has acquired its effectiveness as a motivating operation by accompanying another motivating operation and now has the same value or behavior altering effects as the motivating operation that is accompanied. In other words, when something is paired with something else, now can be interchanged. For example, if you always sit at the dinner table for mealtime, the table and hunger may be paired. As a CMOS, sitting at the dinner table, not at mealtime, may evoke hunger as it acquired motivating properties on its own.
Let's review a more clinical example. In the O'Reilly et al. Article, the researchers found that diverted attention or paying attention to someone else may function as a type of surrogate conditioned motivating operation and evoke attention-maintained problem behavior. A potential intervention is to provide social attention during diverted attention to terminate or unpair the relationship between the surrogate conditioned motivating operation of diverted attention and the motivating operation for attention.
Reflexive conditioned motivating operations, or CMO-R, is a stimulus that acquires its effectiveness as a motivating operation by preceding a situation that either improves, like a reinforcer, or worsens, like a punisher. In other words, being associated by proxy. In this example, let's say you have a little puppy who's not allowed on the couch, but whenever you come home from work, the puppy's laying on the couch. You yell at the puppy to get off the couch, and the puppy runs up the stairs. As a result, the puppy avoids the basement altogether. The basement has become a CMOR. The punishment applied for being on the couch is associated with being in the basement, and the dog avoids the basement altogether.
Now let's discuss a clinical example. In the Carr et al. Article, the researchers examined negatively reinforced problem behavior. The researchers demonstrated that problem behaviors decreased after a stimulus change had been associated by proxy with the removal of demands. The stimulus change was previously neutral, but after preceding the removal of demands became a reflexive conditioned motivating operation.
The last is the transitive conditioned motivating operations, or CMOT. A change in the environment that establishes or abolishes the reinforcing value of another stimulus that evokes or abates the behavior that has been reinforced by other stimuli. In other words, you can't have what you want until another problem is solved. In this example, you want to check a text message or an email, but your phone is locked and you don't know or don't have the password. The password becomes a CMOT because of its established reinforcing value of the passcode to access the message or the email is reinforcing. So you need the password, or you want the password, just as much as you want to check that email or message.
In a clinical example, the researchers in the Sundberg et al. Article contrived transitive conditioned motivating operations in order to teach children with autism to demand or request for information. During the experiment, a toy was initially presented in a container for the child to play with. The empty container, or transitive conditioned motivating operation, evoked the prompted demand for information, or where is the toy, before the child would access or ask for the toy.
We would love to hear your feedback about this video topic, as well as ideas for future videos. Thanks for watching.